So, I will pass over immediately to our second speaker, Dmitry, who will be talking about risk and threats in ABC, if I'm not wrong.
Analysis, here you go. Analysis of risks and trends in automated border control. So in this presentation, I will not be talking about Canadian automated border clearance program. I will be talking about a general automated border control technology of the present and the future. This is a research project which has been funded by the Department of National Defense. And the objective of this project is to generate the critical knowledge for the government of Canada and, of course, with the rest of the world on the use of, in particular, iris and face biometrics for automated border control. So we need to examine the issues with the existing systems and then develop possibly a roadmap for future technologies. So I will be presenting just the short summary of key outcomes, but full details are presented in the report which we have just finished. It's under review right now and it will be in public domain soon. So you're welcome to have a look there. As Jakub, I also would like to quote someone, I don't remember the name, but he said that defining a problem is halfway resolving the problem. So, which highlights the importance of research. As researchers, our key role is to define the problem for our stakeholders. This is a technical presentation, but it is developed for decision makers and stakeholders who are developing visions and programs for the automated border control of the future. So, and here I quickly go through the key outcomes, key points, which have been investigated and obtained through the course of this two-year study. And then I will provide a few more details, visual details, highlighting each of those. So first, there are already a number of biometric-enabled technologies already deployed in airports, but they are working independently from each other. Lots of opportunity to improve it, to leverage technologies, for them to work together. Second point is that biometric has been used in access control for many years, but biometric for border control is very different from access control. This has to be understood and the differences need to be highlighted so that we don't make mistakes in evaluation of those systems. Third, ABC. Very important to understand, it's a technical component, the most important technical component of a bigger process or infrastructure called e-border or smart borders, whatever you call it, specifically for the air traveler continuum, for the mode of transportation by airplane. And in this definition, we identify three types of ABC, not five, not two, but very distinct three classes. One based on pre-enrolled travelers, registered traveler programs. Then generation two is e-gates. They work already with more traffic, everyone who has an e-password. And finally, the one which is common is based on e-border concept. This is where we move from checkpoint to e-border solution. Next point. So we need to know what is e-border. So biometric-enabled authentication is the last and the most critical component. But all other four components are as important. We call them the pillars. Automated border control of the future cannot exist without either of those. These have to be put together in one system eventually. So then you have to define a traveler continuum. We have identified eight distinct zones for technology deployment, specifically aimed at gathering information about the traveler as he buys the ticket and eventually travels and is cleared. And then, of course, we identify new tools for decision making and for analysis. And one of those will be related to continuum-based identification as opposed to point-based identification. So, quickly, you need to understand, it's better always to have a number of pictures. How we work at the moment. We have a border officer who is conducting a short interview. By the way, this is a difference from Europe. I was not asked a single question when I came to, when I arrived. I was surprised. Normally, there would be a few questions. So manual control is important. Then we have already kiosks which use iris biometrics for pre-cleared travelers. Then we have self-search declaration kiosk. We had a presentation today from Vancouver airport. Then we have a temporary resident program which checks fingerprints of students and workers. Then we have e-passports starting from summer 2013. And the picture of my two-year daughter with ICAO compliant face. Here you go, captured a couple of months ago. Now, can all of these be combined together? Yes, of course, it needs to be combined together. And the agency is working on that. The agency has developed a document called Strategy 2020. The idea is to put together all those components in one single piece. And mind you, that all those components are biometric enabled. In each of those technologies, you either already doing biometric authentication or you can do. So, this is why it is important to understand how biometric enabled border control has developed and what are the factors. So it started from access control and it worked only with trained users and it had only biometric component. Then you started deploying registered traveler based programs. Small percentage, less habituated users, low risk. Now you go to the next generation, unknown risk, and much more traffic. And eventually, this is where we're going. We're going to process most of the traffic, and there will be many more factors and components and spread across the entire continuum. So you cannot use the same methodologies developed for access control. You need to develop simulation tools, modeling tools to evaluate and assess the technology. So what are the five pillars of e-border? Always automated plus manual. And the first component is risk-based three-lane processing. Known high risk, known low risk, and unknown risk. And then we have manual behavior screening, essentially by looking at the expression targeting officers are trying to detect suspicious behaviors. Then you try to automate it. A concept of avatar has been introduced recently. But there are many other ideas which can be implemented to automate the interviewing process, to automate detection of suspicious emotions. Then you have self-service kiosks. So we had a presentation today on this border access. The border solution from Vancouver. Here you go. And eventually, the final pillar, which enables it altogether, is biometric-enabled authentication of travelers by face. Maybe iris, maybe fingerprints, all of those together. And we have supporting infrastructure. These five pillars cannot work just by themselves. There is always pre-screening involved, heavy pre-screening. There is e-passport, there is RFIDs, and airport logistics and CCTV cameras. So now you have to define air traveler continuum. From the time the traveler buys a ticket, you know nothing about him. You got API, maybe PNR. Then he arrives to the airport, he declares, or he checks in his luggage, and each of those stages you can put a system which collects evidence, information about who is this person and what is his risk factor. These are two critical travel clearance tasks which need to be done hand in hand throughout the continuum of the process. Now, as he is in plane, you can also monitor his behavior, right? Then he arrives to the airport, and this is where in Canada we are focusing just in port of entry. What can we deploy there? Which technology is available? Okay, video cameras are following a person, maybe matching him to the watch list, if that's possible. but we need to know to what degree it is possible. Then in the queue, also some technologies can be introduced, and already some technologies are introduced. Then at primary inspection lane, you could add e-gates. This is at the present, and already we're talking about entry exit kiosks. So this is what we have right now at the present. Now, what is the future? And we understand now. I think all of us, after this presentation, should have a consensus that the technology of the future will combine all those five pillars in one technology. And how it will look, we may not know, but it has to combine those five pillars in one. It could be a gate, it could be a kiosk, but it should implement all those five pillars. So, essentially, this wraps this very brief presentation. And then, if time allows, later we can talk more about the implications of what I have just presented. Because there are major implications for the research, for the decision makers, how you develop your strategies and vision for the air border control of the future. Thank you.
Thank you very much. The third presentation will be given by Enrique and will be targeting the problem of combating attacks at biometric systems.